everybody out there. Welcome to the channel. Welcome to yet another conference. All honor, glory, and praise be to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Well, I just wanted to have a little chat with you all out there. To just send a word of encouragement out there, I think that we can all benefit from a word of encouragement in these last days, because there's so much going on in the world nowadays, and a lot of people are having a difficult time coping, you know, and that's understandable, because the spiritual warfare is at an all-time high. People out there are struggling to pay their bills and feed their families and maintain their occupations, whether it's self-employed or working for another. You know, everybody, I feel, is trying to be one thing collectively, and that is survive. And so I just wanted to send a word of encouragement out there to somebody. So let me read a scripture to you all, okay? From the book of Matthew, chapter 7, verse 7, in the Holy Bible. The words of Jesus Christ. Ask, and it shall be given you. Seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. For everyone that asketh, receiveth. And he that seeketh, findeth. And to him that knocketh, it shall be opened. I want you to know that God is not a man that he should lie. As a matter of fact, it is impossible for God to lie. Take comfort in that. So no matter what you're going through out there, and everybody's facing something in this world, you can't live in a hellish world such as this and not face demonic opposition. But I gotta tell you that God has got this. And even if there's a shadow of a doubt in your mind that he does, you must resist the devil and he will flee from you. I'm telling you, God has got this. Even if you have to tell yourself this verbally on a daily basis, tell yourself, talk to yourselves about God until you believe the word that you've just received. For many of you out there, you may be waiting on God for something that you asked, you sought, you knocked, and you still don't see the manifestation of it. You must remember that God is not a man that he should lie. And Father knows exactly what type of world this is. He knows what humanity faces on a daily basis. Nothing is too hard for God. You must understand that Father is the one that left the word behind, called the Holy Bible, that told us what the last days would be like. Okay. I'm hearing in my mind, men shall be lovers of their own selves. You know, people are going to be high-minded, stuck on themselves, and live in a very sick, deranged world. But you must come out from among them and be separate. To keep yourselves pure and sane and intelligent and walking in the light and being able to see the true word of God. Jesus is the only light in this world. This is a dark, dark world. Follow the light. A lot of you may be having difficulty in your marriages and relationships and things of that nature. Just give it to God, okay? If you're having problems in your finances, give it to God. See, people that are seeking to obtain more money are maybe facing difficulty obtaining the money. And people that already have the money may be facing difficulty maintaining the money, you know, because money has to turn. You have to live. You have to continue to pay your bills and support yourself and your family, the people that you love, if that be your lifestyle, if that be, you know, something that pertains to your life. And if you are single out here, you know, continue to trust in Father to pay your rent or your mortgage or your car note or whatever your expectation may be. Continue to trust in Father to put food on the table, to keep you afloat in the midst of a raging sea. Trust God's timing. Father knows best. Father knows best. He parted the Red Sea. Moses parted the Red Sea by the power of God, so that the children of Israel could walk through. And they walked through on dry ground. They didn't walk through in slush and mud. See, when God does things, He always does things with taste. Remember that. So when He brings you out of certain situations and circumstances, you must understand that God does things with taste. Proper. God is a God of order. He's a God of law and order. His law and His order. And trust and believe that He will order your steps. Jesus will work it out if you let Him. He'll get every bill paid. He'll make sure food is always on your table. He'll make sure clothes are always on your back. He'll be the glue that holds your marriages and your relationships together. He'll be the man of your dreams. He'll be the one that makes good things happen in your life. Even in the midst of your fiery furnaces, He is there. In the lion's den, He can shut the lion's mouth. A lot of you are dealing with a lot of haters out there. A lot of liars, a lot of deceivers. Jesus is the one that has the power to shut their mouth. And He will, if it be His will. But see, sometimes I believe Father will allow people to continue to talk to hang themselves, so that when the things that they say about you are seen as untrue, well now, who looks like the fool? Them or you? Thank you. You think about that. So for those of you out there that are stressing, and I feel like a lot of times people are, even though